ask the Library District Board of Trustees to order. It is 7:00 PM on Wednesday, March 15th, 2017. Diane, please take the roll.
Okay, Linda?
Here.
Karen? Barbara?
Here.
Rob?
Here.
Tim?
Here.
Carolyn?
Here.
Patty?
Here.
Okay, let's stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Welcome, everybody, to this wonderful spring-like march that we're having. Okay, so the first thing we have is the consent agenda. Want to see if we're able to use a consent agenda again, which just allows to spend our time more productively by voting on the routine matters together. Do I hear a motion to approve the consent agenda, which includes minutes of the regular board meeting of February 15th, 2017, and the payment of bills for operating expenses of $223,722.35, payroll expenses of $263,925.44, and special reserve expenses of $1,217.68, for a total monthly expense of $448,915.47.
So moved.
Barb?
And Patty? $488? It's for, well, the operating expenses are $772, and you said $722.
Shutting over my words. $772. $72. Oh, okay, it was just a typo.
Yeah.
$772.35. Okay. Operating expenses of $223,772.35. Thank you for that. Okay, does anyone want either of these items removed from the consent agenda?
Would like a little more elaboration in the minutes, so does that mean we should remove that?
Yep. Okay. Okay, so, we'll remove the minutes, and we'll just approve the expenses for right now. So, do you want to hold on? Was any discussion about the...
No, you just take the little on the consent agenda, and then we discuss the minutes. The expenses, the consent agenda means no discussion.
So nobody needs to make the motion?
It's your motion. Well, yeah, I guess you have to make a motion to remove.
Okay, so take them, let's remove the motion to do a consent agenda, and should I just go over and just swap them out, just do them individually? Why don't I do that?
Yeah.
Okay, Barb, you retract your motion.
Yes.
Patty, you retract your second. Okay. So I would like to make a motion for the payment of the bills for the operating expenses of $223,772.35, payroll expenses of $263,925.44, special reserve expenses of $1,217.68, for a total monthly expense of $488,915.47.
So moved.
Second. Barb, Patty? Any discussion? Diane, please take the roll.
Hey, Barbara?
Yes.
Rob?
Yes.
Tim?
Yes.
Carolyn?
Yes.
Patty?
Yes.
Linda?
Yes. Okay, so now I would like to make a motion to approve the minutes of the regular board meeting of February 15th, 2017.
So moved.
Barb?
Second.
Patty? Any discussion?
Yes, I just wanted to add more detail to one of the paragraphs about discussion of trustee procedures regarding request for information. That, this is a very general statement. I think specifically you were addressing my email to Greg, and I'd like that to be in here, so we understand what the problem is. and that it was denied, and that it was denied by a vote of the board. Because that's important.
I didn't feel that it was just for that. I feel like that was a real position that we've been talked about, not just that in one case.
My request for information was denied by a vote by this board, and it's not in the minutes, and I'd like it to be placed in the minutes.
Oh, I understand.
So that's where my email to Greg.
Oh, I understand.
That was denied should be included in these minutes. So if you have that, if you need me to send it to you, I'll be more than glad to send it to you, Diane. And then you can explain that it was, there was a vote that was denied based on this report.
There was no vote. It was just that nobody voted to have it.
They decided.
They decided, but they did not vote.
Okay, well, their decision should be in a roll call vote, or it shouldn't be, it shouldn't take place. So if this board's, conversations have weight, how do you want that to proceed? With a vote or without a vote? Do you need a vote?
If the board is giving me direction, then it's up to the president to determine the feeling of the board.
Okay, my request to Greg was denied. Why? Because the board agreed unanimously that he didn't need to do that? Am I misunderstanding?
We can reflect that in there if you'd like.
I wanted to, well, she's saying that there wasn't a vote, so I'm asking who decided I do not need to receive this information?
Well, it wasn't a vote, it was just a consensus. It was just, it wasn't a vote, it was just a.
Any of us wanted the information, wasn't it?
Okay, so my request was denied because of a consensus of the board, not a vote of the board. It's fine, that terminology is just as good.
Perfect. Anything else? Okay. Can we have a roll call, please? Linda? Oh, sorry. It's Barbara?
Yes.
Rob?
Yes.
Tim?
Yes, thank you.
Carolyn?
I'm sorry, we're voting on.
On the minutes.
So we're not approving them because they need to change, right?
I will make the change.
We're adding the change.
Okay, what did they change?
Mm-hmm.
Ah, yeah.
Patty?
Yes.
Linda?
Yes.
Carol?
Yes.
Okay, is there any comments? Any public comments? Okay, next item on the agenda is treasury report, Greg.
Okay, so we started getting our real estate tax distributions from the county again. However, we were just a little bit off of our estimates for the month by $8,700. And we exceeded expectations for the year by $264,000. Our salaries were pretty much dead on. There was about a $425 difference for the month, and we were short on budget estimates for $64,000 or 3% for the year. Library materials for the month, $13,500 under budget or 22%, $32,000 over budget or 6.6% for the year, due primarily to annual subscription fees and database product offerings that are paid off in full and earlier in the calendar. Library operating expenses, $3,000 under budget, 9.4% for the month, $35,000 under budget or 13.8% year to date. And this is due to slow spending in per capita software, the printing line items. General administrative expenses, $6,000 over budget estimates for the month, 24.4%, and almost $36,000 under budget or 18.4% year to date. And this is due to slow spending and the consultant promotional and legal line items. Employee fringe benefits is almost $2 million over budget due to the payment of $2 million to IMRF to reduce our liability. Utilities is within $2,000 budget expense monthly and within $10,000 year to date. And then the month, The net surplus is $348,000, which is $40,000 favorable to the budgeted net surplus of $308,000 and $1,416,000 unfavorable year-to-date. Any questions?
I have a question about the balance sheet or the, and the income statements. I'm trying to find the monthly payment to IMRF. Could you help me locate that? I don't know where it is.
Monthly payment to IMRF is, actually, the payment that we're, that hits our income statement is on page 19.
And it's?
Under deferred compensation.
Okay, so deferred compensation is the monthly payment to IMRF?
And this past month it was $19,162.
Okay, perfect. And then I noticed on.
However, we actually transferred about $30,000 to IMRF because what we transferred is the part that we pay and the part that's withheld from the employees' paychecks. So it's 4.5%, which is withheld from the employees' paychecks, and then we're matching at 8.12%.
So the.
So this is just the 8.12%.
So how, well, we're not paying their 4%, you're just forwarding their money, is that what you're saying?
Yeah, yeah.
But this is.
But you asked, how much did we pay IMRF?
Okay, I appreciate it. And then about the general fund where it shows deferred revenues?
Yeah.
Are we, is this a yearly figure or a monthly figure? Because we're repeating the $2 million each month.
Yeah, so we make, remember, these are done on a modified accrual basis, which is kind of close to a cash basis. And at the end of the year, we make accrual entries such as deferred revenue and accounts receivable. So we don't adjust those except on a annual basis after the close of the year.
So you carry it, you just carry it, okay, good, because I thought I had the wrong page in the wrong year or month, and then I was afraid we're not adding another $2 million. Okay, perfect, thank you, that helped the month.
Any more questions? Next item on the agenda is Director's Report.
Okay, I have some updates for you. Last month, we talked about the library rules and we revisited the idea of people conducting business in the library, and we agreed that Dennis and I would talk about that. I have sent Kleinthorpe all of the library rules because I want to just make sure that they are all, because he had concerns about freedom of speech and there are things about candidates passing out literature and things like that. So I sent him the whole thing and asked Kleinthorpe to review all of the rules. So that is in process, but it is not done yet. Passport service, I had a meeting with the person I'm consulting with, Leah White. Sadly, from my point of view, she did not think that my ideas were good ones. She did not like where I had planned to put the desk. She did not like, because she thought it should be at one desk, not spread onto two floors like I wanted to do. She did not think it was a good idea to use people from multiple departments. She thinks that people work much better in one department. So I am a little bit back to square one, but I have continued to investigate what other libraries are doing, and I have talked to a couple of people in-house that are very interested in working on this. So it is continuing, but I will confess, a little bit of a setback. I liked my plans, so I was a little disappointed. But also, she said, this is their very peak time of year. This is the time of year when everybody who wants to be traveling is getting their passport. So she said, don't even try calling them right now. Don't try calling the State Department right now. Wait until May, probably, to actually start confirming things. So that gives me a little time to continue making plans. So that's where that is now.
Is she the person that will be able to help you set this up?
Yes.
Okay, so she'll be able to tell you the hours that she, her employees spend on it? Or give you an idea so we can get a cost?
Well, I already know what the hours are at ELA. They basically offer passport service during the hours that they're open, except for they stop at an hour before closing to close out the books for the day.
Well, I meant the cost for us to have this available. What is it costing her?
It will, yeah, it will depend 100% on what level of employee staff that is.
And what level of employees is she using?
She is using mostly paraprofessionals.
And what's her cost?
I know that she has, like, I don't know, it's a different size library, and at that desk, they do multiple things, so.
Does she feel there's a need for a certain qualification level, or can you train someone who's not?
She seemed to think that the more important thing was that they were organized and competent and had great customer service skills, that there are, so that there are some qualifications, but it's not necessarily related to education. So, that was.
That's good to know. All right, thank you.
So that you can have a lesser paid.
Hopefully, if we can figure out a good way to do that. So that's what I'm working on.
And then I just have one more thing. So then you were saying that if they weren't working on that, then maybe it was a multi-task type desk, so that there's other things that they would be doing time rather than just sit there and wait for the next page.
Right, yeah, that desk, that, Mila, is the desk as you are walking in the building. It's the first desk that you see. It's actually a gigantic boat of a desk. It's bigger than this table. And they have four stations at it, and it's where they look, they have their popular materials, and they have, they answer the phone when somebody rings to bypass the message, so they do a number of things at that desk. It's the popular materials desk.
So it's not just one person just sitting there kind of waiting for me?
Oh, gosh, no.
Okay, that's good.
No, and she knows that, you know, to staff up or down depending on the time of day, but, you know, to some extent, it's unpredictable, yeah. So I just wanted to tell you that I am a member of the Arts and Culture Council, and we met on Monday night, and we got the first report back from the Lakota group on the community surveys that have been done and the stakeholder interviews that have been done. And I was really happy to see in the first report that they asked people, where do you go to for cultural events, and the library came up number one. So that was great to hear.
It's the only place for cultural events.
Well, they also put parks in schools, but but I was obviously pleased by that, and and it seems like it's going off in a good direction, so it was good to hear. So next month they will be presenting the next phase of the master plan, kind of updating the, they're still doing the surveys right now, so they'll be updating it next month, and then going, I think, to the trustees in May. So that is interesting, and it's good work to see getting done, and it's a great place for the library to get its information out and for us to get, you know, I wrote down several ideas for what we could be doing, and so I think it's a great thing. It's finally starting to gel. The first couple of years of it seemed very fragmented and kind of all over the place, but it's kind of finally starting to move things forward. I think the library will be a very key part of that work. Let's see, last month I passed out the effective board meetings packet, which Mr. Spadoni, you did not get, and I should hand to you right now. And we talked about bringing it back for a vote this month, but I thought maybe it would be better to wait until May when there are new trustees, rather than going through it again. So I hope it's all right, but I did not bring that back for tonight. See, the budget timeline, I wanted to just confirm with you that what we have agreed upon now is that you will get your first presentation of the budget at next month's board meeting. The following week, April 26th, I believe it is, you will be getting, we'll have a special board meeting. It's going to be at 7:15, so come at Carol's schedule. And that is where, that's where.
26th, excuse me, what time is it?
7:15.
Thank you.
It's a Wednesday. Again, it's basically the Wednesday after next month's board meeting. So that will be your second chance to review the budget after you've had a first look at it. It's your chance to go through it more line by line. Sasha will be preparing a press release to go out to the local newspaper so that the public will be informed if they want to attend. And it will be voted on at the June meeting, presumably.
When is the June meeting?
The only other thing about that is I was going to invite the trustee candidates to the special board meeting.
That is all I have. Is anybody have any questions?
That meeting will be after the election. But I thought, as a courtesy, I would let them know when it's going to be so they get it on their calendar.
Oh, I'm sorry. I think candidates is not.
They won't be candidates by then.
Okay.
Right, there'll be the hearing for the budget will also be at the June meeting. first that and then the two committee.
Right, this, yeah, 6:21, so they're usually about like 5 minutes before?
It is usually set for 5 minutes before, and it will run as long as it needs to run. Historically, nobody has ever come to it, but it's there for them if they want to say something.
I'm not sure what kind of shape that we have.
Well, you know, I think tentatively I have here that you would vote on the tentative budget in May, and then you could postpone the final vote on the budget for later.
It's just, I'm having surgery on the first.
Okay.
And I don't know how long I'll be moving.
Okay. So that's all I have for that.
I have a comment on page 23. I think it's absolutely outstanding and inspired to use the pizza slices for both math and tying into our pizza exhibit.
And Pi Day yesterday.
And Pi Day.
Oh, yes, Pi Day, yep.
It's inspired. I thought it was just marvelous.
Let's see.
And then next page on 24, big shout out to Dodi. Dodi, is it? Dodi for the 115 attendees, right? That's fantastic. How many people fit in?
120 is the max.
Oh, my gosh.
And that's usually with like the little kids squeezed on the floor, so I'm not even sure how they got that many people in on chairs.
Yeah, so outstanding.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, excellent. Great, and that's the record of that. It's phenomenal.
I know, I came here the last time I was here, and it was just...
It's kind of disappointing, right, too, because we...
Is it entirely in Polish, I presume?
Yeah, yeah.
And it's people from all over. They come, it's not just our residents, it's other people from our... Northway, west suburbs. Okay, is that everything?
Yeah.
Okay, communications, so...
I do have on page 36, under communications, I just gave you this as a sample. I sent a letter to each one of our legislators.
I was wondering if this was just to Fran Chakowski or...
No, I did it to all of them. This is just the one that happened to be the one that took her, but I did it to... I looked them all up, and we have like eight. It's a lot of people because the district is...
So then there's state senators, state reps.
Yep, I did them all. Yes, and so I wanted to just, you know, let them know about the name change as a courtesy, but also take the opportunity to invite them to come use the library to meet with their constituents or anything else that they might want to do. John Walrow has done that in the past, but most of the others have not. So I'd be very happy to have them in here. It's just that the district is so split up that, you know, most of them probably feel like they would get critical mass by coming here. They're welcome to do it.
Right. We had heard at the breakfast that we went to from Laura Murphy, who's a state senator, at the Plains Library, has open hours where she can talk to constituents there. She really appreciated the opportunity to talk to her constituents every once in a while. So I think it's a good use of our space, too.
Good. Yeah, it was after we went to the legislative breakfast that I came back, and we got busy, you know, making sure I knew exactly who everybody was, and then sending out the letter.
That's all right. Okay, thank you. So, committee reports, building and grounds, Barbara?
Well, I think if this is a lumpy, can update us on the signage, because you've been talking with Dan Portman.
Yes, I have. I have a very rough estimate of how much each of the signs will cost, but they have to be updated because of changing the library name. And we were debating whether we thought it was a good idea to go ahead and pull the sign that would label the front of the library out of the package and just proceed with it. But I think it's probably going to be better to keep the whole thing as a package and send it out to bid together. So next month, I will have a proposed bid package for you guys to vote on whether you want to go down to bid on the whole thing or not. And then we'll proceed. I'd love to get some signage up in place for July 1, and we certainly will try to rush that one piece of it ahead, but I don't want there to be a public perception that we're pulling things out to reduce the size of the bid package.
You know what, if you start pulling stuff apart, it's not going to be like humpy dumpy. You're not going to be able to put it back together.
Yeah. That way I can consult it.
It would also affect the price.
Well, exactly. Right, that's exactly right.
Yeah.
So we'll do it all as one. So that's where that is.
Well, we were thinking to get it mainly from one vendor anyway, right?
It probably will, yes.
Consistent.
Yes.
I mean, that would be our...
We just have to give more than one vendor a chance to bid on it.
Right.
The vendor that works, that gave us the quote initially is the one that did all the interior signage before. So that's what we started with, but yeah, we'll have to put it up there.
Okay. All right, next item on the agenda is liaison report, Friends of Library, Carolyn.
We had a meeting on Monday. A few things. Susan did present the perpetual knowledge sign, and there were also some discussions by Luella Preston about books for preschoolers. She's concentrating on 3 and 5 year olds. Looks like the 3 year olds, it may be specific to 3 year olds because they think that may be a better targeted group, but we're not sure. Let's see. Oh, and then the treasurer's report was submitted to the board, and because of the inaccuracies in the figures, what's his name? Rich was Wozniak, I don't know how to pronounce his last name, needs to provide some explanation in writing. Apparently there's over $20,000 difference between the treasurer's report they received on Monday and the last treasurer's report, which has something to do with your decision to move the money.
Okay, so.
I don't know, was there anything else discussed, Susan? I know that was pretty lengthy, but was...
That was pretty well. Well, they were very unhappy with the board's decision. They do think of the book sale money as their money. They, everything that I brought to them, like the funding the Shakespeare project, they were saying, well, we should get the board to pay for that. So they are pretty unhappy about it. But you know, we'll see if they are going to move forward. They did have the nice idea from Luella Preston of distributing the books to 3 year olds. And there was a lot of discussion about how the mechanics of how they would do that. So.
But the key at the meeting was your movement of the money should have been corresponded to them in writing. What they're trying to say is you can't just do something and then not advise them. So that's where this written communication needs to come in. And that was the conversation they had with Rich. Susan, are you part of that?
I believe what they said is that Chris Fendusiakis, president of the Friends, will write a letter to the board requesting an accounting of that money so that it can be removed from their books.
And then the treasurer's report will be corrected.
That's
okay.
Because it was already shown that it was.
Rich had been putting on the treasurer's report each month how much money they expected to get. So that would have to be backed out, basically. Okay. They wanted something
sense.
In writing to do that. Yeah, I mean, they were officially informed of the decision. I had written them an email a couple of days after you made that decision. But yeah, they were right. The exact notes. So.
Okay. Right, and did you have in the letter that it was with our lawyer's guidance?
I don't know that back then, I don't know that it did say anything.
Okay, well, maybe that was premature before we had discussed it with him also.
Well, I had discussed it with him.
Oh, okay.
But this, you know, last meeting
right.
Was very quick.
Yes, okay. All right, legislative, Susan?
Just that we attended the legislative office. Yeah, it was very interesting, I thought, with Rob mm-hmm. and Karen and Dodie and I all.
Oh, that's nice. And anything they wanted to share?
I think one thing that the speaker talked about, I think was a discussion of news and fake news. And
yeah.
Our responsibility as a library to be a disseminator of correct and true facts. You know, that's one of the things that we do. So, and I think there's an encouragement to support our local news media and what they do in terms of getting out factual information to the public.
I would like to hear that.
It was great.
Yeah. And it was a beautiful day. Wasn't it like 80 that day or something?
Yeah.
Oh my God! Yeah. There were people golfing.
Yeah.
Oh my Lord! Oh, wow.
Crazy. Okay, Rails?
There will be a meeting in a couple of weeks.
Okay. Let's see, Barbara, can you please read the secretary's report?
Okay. A certified copy of ordinance 17-01, the ordinance changing the library district's name to the Niles Main District Library, effective July 1st, 2017, was filed with the Cook County Recorder of Deeds with a recording fee of $40, the Cook County Treasurer's Office, and the Cook County Clerk on February 16th, 2017.
Okay, so what I would like to do with the new business, A, B, and C, if I could actually do B first, to adopt a new mission statement, engage, inform, enrich, and educate, before A and C, just to make it actually run a little smoother. So I would like to hear a motion to adopt a new mission statement for the library, engage, inform, enrich, and educate.
So moved.
Dr. Barb and Patty, any discussion?
I have a question. What is needed? Okay, how, I'm a little confused. How are those four words, how do those relate to page 40? Where it says mission statement, and it's
page 40 is our current mission statement, and this would be to replace that.
Oh, okay, thank you. Okay. I like the four words.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, I thought they said that's
it. It's got a little bit more of a pout factor.
What can I actually do with page 40? Oh, no, it's here.
Okay, any further discussion?
Well, I have something to say. It's a little odd because I guess I'm the one that put that in the last meeting. But I thought it was going to be incorporated into something maybe a little larger. I've always understood a mission statement to be something, a complete statement as to what we're going to do, as in the mission of the Niles Main District Library is to engage, inform, enrich, educate the residents of our district. You know, something that is more of a, this is what I'm going to do, not just four words tossed out.
Right. I agree.
Well, we could.
And it doesn't have to be nearly as large as the one
right
that's there. I agree, it's a little wordy.
Well, what if you made it basically what you just said, the mission of the Niles Main District Library is to engage, inform, enrich, and educate the community, or the residents. It's residents.
It's like residents. Yeah, I'm fine with that. Just needs to be a
complete sentence.
A complete sentence.
Right. I don't know if you want to just do the residents, because not just residents.
Patrons.
Because it'd be patrons. Anybody who came, or even people who just visited our website. Or, you
yeah.
Know,
yeah.
It's way
yeah.
bigger than yeah. just our residents.
So patrons.
Patrons, yeah. Community patrons, something like that. That's a good point, Jim.
I think it's a very good point. What's the patrons?
Where is our current mission statement you mentioned?
Page 40.
Page 40.
Page 40.
Yeah.
But I do like the simplistic, or simplicity of the four words. I really like those powerful words.
Pull it out in a
right.
variety of ways.
Right.
Yes.
That's what you put on the bag
yeah.
to say.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right. Right.
It's a
dangling
yeah. So I yeah. All right. I'm going to go with that.
Okay. So do I change?
The motion would have to be amended.
Okay.
So what do we have to do? Which,
Tim, do you want to amend the motion?
I will amend the motion.
Is that how we would do it?
Yeah, it makes a friendly amendment.
Yeah.
Okay.
Friendly.
To your honor.
Motion, right?
So say what you want it to be.
The mission of the Niles Main District Library is to engage, inform, enrich, and educate its patrons.
It's Very good.
And I accept that amendment.
I second it.
Okay. Any further discussion?
Hey, Barbara?
Yes.
Rob?
Yes.
Tim?
Yes.
Carolyn?
Yes.
Patty?
Yes.
Linda?
Yes.
Karen?
Yes.
All right, so now we'll go to pay, which is, we will now take some time to discuss the draft of the strategic plan. Susan, can you please refresh our memories about what this is and how it was developed?
So this is based on, initially, Rob and Kim did stakeholder interviews, and we got over 300 surveys back from the patrons of the library and the staff. Then we all came together at the strategic planning retreat, and we heard the results of that information gathering that they did, and people voted using dots to designate which things they thought were the most important to move forward on, and then Kim and Rob grouped these things and got back to us. Then they came back with this draft of four separate categories. I made one significant change to it, which was they had made one of the categories expanded programming, I think it was. And when I looked at the votes from the retreat, it was clear that programming was way below some of the other things, but some other things kind of needed more fleshing out. So I developed the category of focused staff development to give staff the expertise to work with the community effectively, incorporating some of the programming points that they had, but adding a couple of other things. So these are things that we already talked about. The main themes of it, I think, are that number one thing that came out of the retreat was that marketing needed to be seriously looked at, because we offer so many services and collections and wonderful things, but people have a hard time knowing what we offer. Mm-hmm. So it's to really focus on that. That was number one. There were some things about that some people found the building itself still very confusing to navigate, and so to work very much on wayfinding and navigation, and to improve consistency in customer service from desk to desk, do some customer service work with the staff. And then to improve our work with both the people that live far away and the people that don't have English as their first language, which is an overlapping group, but also two separate groups. So that's what it ended up with. So we made it, instead of, they had called it outreach, we call our delivery department outreach, so I didn't want to use that word because I thought that would be very confusing to everyone. So we, a lot of libraries are calling it community engagement now. So that's what that phrase means, is basically getting out of the library, getting the community involved in the library. So that's kind of the overview. And then the next step of this plan will be, once you guys have approved it, then I will be working with Kim and Rob and a core of staff members to develop the actual work of carrying this plan out. And that will also come back to you for a vote. So you need to vote on this to get us started. Mm-hmm. Or if you want to make a lot of changes, then we would probably want to discuss it again next month and then bring it back for a vote.
So can I ask a question? Who's presenting this? Is this coming
from the consultants? The consultants did the framework, and then I made a few tweaks, but this is basically what they presented.
Okay, so
the idea of it was that I would get the first whack at it, and Linda would get a chance to look at it, and then it would come to you.
Okay, so this is what we're getting from our consultants
and the
whole process.
Yep.
Okay, I actually looked at this and compared it to the one in January. I did note the differences. Definitely there are four categories, and obviously the four categories we have now are much more relative to what we want to do. So I certainly agree with all of that. But I've gone through the four categories, and I've gone through all of your bullet points, and I understand we need to approve this. And what I'd like to do is make a motion that either the consultants or whoever put this together provide the board with a strategic plan that specifically states what your results would be in these categories, and then explain the bullet points with what you plan to do to reach that goal. The allotted amount of time, is it a one-year goal, a five-year goal, and actually the cost associated with it. Now, to me, that's a plan we should prove. because this is a grid of generalizations, and I don't understand why we would be approving something at this stage, not knowing what it's going to cost us and how long it's going to take you to accomplish what in fact you plan on accomplishing, because there's nothing specific in these bullet points. They're extremely general. So I'd like to know specifically, are results going to be this? Instead of, it almost seems flowery. So I'd like something more precise. And I'd like my motion to be that you come back to us with specifics, including a timeline and cost for these great ideas, but I'm not sure exactly what those ideas are.
So isn't that the next step?
Yeah. Yes. My understanding was that is our second step that we have to vote on.
Right.
Correct.
This is like a huge, this just gives
them where to launch off from. And then the second step, they would be coming to us with the information you're asking, and then we have to vote on that.
So
that's what I read when I was reading this.
So then this is just something you want to talk about for another month, and then you're going to bring us a strategic plan to vote on?
No, this is the strategic plan. These are the goals that the board is setting for the library, should you choose to vote for it. Then the work of figuring out the steps that you would have to take to accomplish each one of these goals will then be presented to the board, and the cost associated with it then. This is a 3 to 5 year plan, so this is definitely not going to get done right away. But this is the idea, this is the direction that the board is instructing the staff to begin working in. These are the things that you think is important for our community that you want us to be working on.
With community input, with staff input,
the input from the community was quite small. And
actually, it's very quite comparable to any other input.
No,
in any
one businessman attending a meeting doesn't speak to the business population, for starters. I mean, this is fine. It's like I said, it's not very specific. And what I am concerned about is just now going over all these different sessions you had. I was aware of the community leaders that you met with.
Yes.
And I wasn't sure what the purpose of that meeting was. I know it was a lunch, and then everyone was supposed to discuss ideas or
focus group
or make suggestions. Yeah. So what came out of that meeting? What I heard doesn't make sense. But what was the result of that meeting? And did you get input from them? Is that what the purpose was?
Well, it was a focus group. They went through the same questions roughly with all of the groups of people, and they said that discussion was one of the best ones that they had, because they had lots of things to say to each other, and they were very interested. They said it was a great, very free-flowing conversation, and they incorporated that into the results that they gave you at the strategic planning retreat.
So then what was the result of the library's interaction with the business, what did you call them?
If I can
the community leaders, I'm not saying
it. I understand, but okay. I don't think this is a time that we're talking about the different focus groups. I think we're past that. I think this is a time we're discussing.
Okay, I want to make a point, please.
Let me finish.
No, I'm talking, and I'm tired of you interrupting.
Excuse me, I'm the president. And
I don't care who you are.
I organized the meeting. I organized the meeting.
Okay, and when I finish asking my question,
is about focusing on what changes we would like for this plan.
Okay,
not about the focus groups.
Okay, it is. And if you would stop being so rude, everything isn't as limited to
could
how you
think.
Could
you please bring your voice level down?
Thank you.
Okay, then we switch your seat.
Fight me.
Susan, the input I received from some of the community leaders was that you suggested or asked them what our staff can do for them. And one of the suggestions was that our staff would provide workshops or classes at the Park District. And I'm a little concerned about that, because I don't feel that we should utilize our revenues for our staff to save the Park District money on their classes. So that's why I'm trying to figure out, how does that fit into this strategic plan of yours, since it was such a very good meeting you had with community leaders? I mean, the library is not here for that purpose.
Just to be clear, I was not in that. I was not in any of the focus groups except the one with you guys. The results are whatever the consultant said. John Jacket did attend that, and so I think it was in the context of the kind of long, funny shape that the Village of Niles has, and our district extends even beyond that. And so it was talking in the context of how do we reach the people up at the north end of the district, and it was being discussed in that context, that working with the Gulf Main Park District is an opportunity for us to expand our service to the people that have a hard time getting down to us. The Niles Park District was not at that meeting, and I don't think it was in that context.
Well, because, well, the response was that it would save him money. I says, wait a minute, we're not here to save you money, we're here to save us money. So, I mean, so his thought is our staff would replace his staff.
Not at all, no.
So that I just need clarification there, because, I mean, I don't know why we would have our staff running around doing that. And I don't know who told him that, if not you. I thought you were running these meetings.
Of course not, the consultants ran all the focus groups.
So it was...
I wasn't even in the room. So I introduced them to everyone, and then I walked away.
And they made that decision?
Yes, that was intended, so I wasn't even in the staff one. And they actually did the staff one blind, so I couldn't even tell them.
So our consultants are telling the Park District that our staff will provide classes?
No, no, the Park District, the group, so I'm assuming it would be John, but it wouldn't necessarily be John. They were talking about, you know, what do you, I think one of the questions might have been along the lines of what problems do you see for the library? You know, what are some of the issues that you face? And clearly one of our issues is that we're down at the south end of the district and we have a lot of our people up at the north end.
Well, he told me that it was presented to him that we would be willing to take care of his classes with our staff. And I said, that doesn't make any sense. So that's why I was bringing that up, because I wasn't sure what came out of this. And I didn't even know you weren't there. So that's kind of, actually, that's a little...
And maybe that could be addressed.
That's a little concerning.
Well, but I mean, the idea is, though, I actually don't want to think of that as a negative thing. I think it's a very positive thing. We want to build relationships with our community partners so that we are able to offer service at the north end of the district and all around the district. And that's one of our key places to do that.
Oh,
so
absolutely.
I actually want that understood as this is part of the expanded community engagement. We would want to do that. If not, everybody's going to make it down here for our technology classes. So if we have a technology class up there, that's not the purpose of a park district. But we could bring that service to some of the people that would find that a convenient place to go.
Well, that's a completely different spin on it. And of course, before we even engage in that, we'd have to get a perfectly good understanding of our current staffing and what our needs are and what we're doing. But that's a completely different description.
Right, and not only that, it would, again...
But thank you for allowing me to ask my question.
And after that, that would be something that would be...
Lower your voice level.
And that would be something that we would talk about still afterward, and it would still be talked about at the board.
Yes.
So...
Now, my only concern about approving this now is historically with this board, we approve gray areas, and then when I find out a year or two now, we're doing things that are very costly, and I'm told, well, you approved it as a board. You approved it as a board. So I would prefer to approve something, I mean, to give you the go-ahead to try to analyze or to try to figure out what's involved to reach these goals is fine, but to give you a blessing to spend money on this until we realize the cost and if it's worth it are two different things. So am I misunderstanding your steps here?
Yes, this is just a discussion.
If what you're asking for an approval
would be about
this. Of this plan.
But right. This has not committed us to spend any money.
No.
To have our staff spend how much time to put this together? What are we talking about here? Another month?
Well, I mean, it's not on the agenda for you to vote on this tonight, so because I needed to find out if you thought we were on the right track.
Right.
It
right.
will come to you in April for you to vote on. Once you have voted on it, that's when I will start working with the consultants on fleshing out a plan that would have more of the details. But if you don't think that expanded community engagement is important and you don't want us spending our effort on planning for how to do that, and this doesn't say right in the top line, develop a task force, that's going to be time consuming.
Well, before you can engage in all of this, we need to figure out just what's going on here in our own library.
Well, our library is not a building. Our library is a library district.
I'm talking about staff. Okay. What they're doing now and who you're going to be able to move from this location to another location. Why? Because nothing's going on here? Is it slow during the day? Is it an ideal opportunity for our staff to have something more engaging to do? I mean, just think of it. Are we talking about additional staff? So, I mean, there's a lot that's going on here. All I'm asking is, in April, when you want us to vote, what will you be presenting to us then?
I will not be presenting anything except this. There will not be additional details. That is the next step.
Well, I don't think this board could vote on a strategic plan without noting, knowing the time element involved, the staff requirements, and the cost.
So what are we voting at? Will be up to you guys. If you decide you cannot approve this, then you decide you can't approve it. But this would be the strategic plan. I want to be clear about that. The steps might end up changing. This is the plan. So if you don't like the plan tonight, it would be really helpful if you would tell me that and get me on a better track. I'd love to hear more from the other trustees.
I'd like to say that I like the plan so far. And the goals generally are fairly open-ended, but I think they give you some direction as to where you should, if we assume we approve it, practical, concrete solutions or actions we can take after that. But I understand we need us to approve this first. I think if any board members really object to the goals themselves, this is the time to articulate that objection, this is the time to say that. But if the goals themselves are acceptable, I think we should vote in favor of this. Then, when Susan and her staff develop ways of carrying out the goals, if we object to particular ways of carrying out the goals, maybe based on the cost, maybe based on other reasons, then I'm sure we'll have an opportunity to discuss that. Now, Carolyn, I'm not sure if you're asking how much time it's going to take to develop the ways of carrying out the strategic plan, is that what you're asking?
Absolutely. Just take a line item. Yeah. That's what I'm saying.
I don't know if you can say how many staff hours are going to be required.
1 year, 20 people.
To come up with practical, you know, steps to implement the plan. I don't know if you could do that or not.
You know, I'm kind of figuring it's a minimum of a month, but it's, I don't know in terms of hours. I really, because I haven't done this piece of it before, so I don't really know from the consultants how long it's likely to be. Some of this is, I have to say, really hard stuff. Some of these things are not going to be easy. The evaluating the service model and staffing models throughout the library with the goal of freeing resources for community engagement is going to be hard. Because, you know, we have all these desks and we have expectations for the services we provide. So that's going to be a lot of hard work. How long it'll take us to figure out what the steps are of that is also going to take some work. So honestly, I'd love to get it back to you within a month. I think realistically it might be a couple if I want to give you a really solid plan. If you want costs associated with it, then that's going to take some development.
I think it would be helpful. Are you going to be the person in charge of all of this?
In what sense,
you just mentioned about going through the different areas of the library, which is so time consuming, and determining your services or your allocations of your desks or whatever.
Right.
That's you, or are you going to appoint other people to do this?
Well, I mean, that's the question, is we'd have to figure that out. The goal is to evaluate the service model, the steps of carrying that out are what will be part of the work plan, but I don't know right now.
So you're evaluating your current service model to change it, is that what you're saying?
Exactly,
with
the goal of freeing resources for community engagement.
Right. So now, that's a very interesting statement then. So that would mean that there's room to curtail the hours at the library, so that people can leave this location to go somewhere else.
Well, people leave the library all the time, just to be clear.
No, when I have
school liaisons and people that are out in the community
all
the time.
Sure, but I'm saying that would mean then maybe like during the day when you have a slow period, that's when you have people in our district giving classes or whatever. So it would be just have them relocating from place to place as opposed to being here.
But that's to look and see if that's how it would work. You have to do programs though when people are available, so. Like you can't have a school liaison go out to the school at night because they're not there.
Right, as a matter of fact, I noticed that letter you received about a lady was complaining about that as well. Perfect timing for our
strategic planning.
That email that you received from a patron
about
who felt that you offer more classes during the day as opposed to at
night.
Right. So that would fall right into here. Okay, well that's my concern.
Overall looks great. To me, the last focus is really the goal.
Yeah.
My suggestion would be to change that to the goal, to enhance community awareness and alignment. And the focus, the strategic focus is to improve marketing, or just marketing, period. And the...
So you would basically put the identified barriers to customer service and communication as the goal, rather than the connecting the right people with the right...
Right, so to enhance community awareness and alignment, it would be the goal.
Yeah, it almost needs to be broken out into a fifth category. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, because the investments are all based on that, that part of it, there's not really, so...
Well, I will admit that I snuck that in there because that wasn't represented in here anywhere, and I thought that was, that did kind of boil it down to what, I don't want to lose sight of that, because that's the really important piece. And that's the category, I snuck it in because I couldn't see where else to put it, but...
Right, but implementing new target communication across relevant markets, right? I know that came up quite a few times.
Overall, again, I like it as well. The very first one, the outcome and the exceptional customer service, I'm not real big on identifying one particular group that sounds a little trendy. I'd rather say library is easy to use for all its patrons, because identifying cultural background, well, why not physical limitations or age or any other factor that you...
Well, I think certainly those are factors as well. I think there are many factors that you, where you have, can break down the patrons into different groups. The cultural background, I think, had a little bit to do with the fact that some cultures don't even have libraries. And you know, like, there's an ongoing battle here over feet on the furniture, where some of our cultures think it's basically, it's dirty to wear shoes in the house, so they take their shoes off when they settle into an area, and other people think it's dirty to sit on the furniture with your, with, without wearing your shoes. So you have, it's sort of to develop some cultural sensitivity to competing points of view on things, so that you can talk to people in a way that's respectful to their backgrounds. But you don't know what that is until you ask. It's to learn a little bit more about that. That was, I think, part of the idea behind that. I think it goes hand in hand with the non-English speakers, but it's also some different things. But, you know, so you're saying you would make it the library's easy to use,
for all
period.
For all
patrons.
Just open it up. And the expanded community engagement, I spoke about this before, I'm not real big on that. This is our, essentially our center of village. We've got the village hall here, and the post office, and the senior center, and the fitness center, and we've got the library. This is our, this is it. You can't come to the center of town. We've got free bus service. We're one of the few communities in the entire country that has a free bus service. I think maybe that goal might be a little too lofty, to provide library services to all residents, regardless of their physical location.
We talked about that.
I mean, how do you achieve that, other than our services are already available through the internet? We can't possibly provide physical services to everybody, regardless of location. That's insane. Well, and I don't think any other library really tries to do that. Arlington Heights or...
Well, I think they do try. I think that's
any
library's...
They have multiple locations. I don't know.
I think it's any library's goal. I did take out, they had had to provide equal library services to all residents, and I thought that was not realistic. Not going to get there, so I'm going to put that to the writing. I take your point, but, you know, I do... You have to remember, though, that that we are the center of the village of Niles, but not of the district.
But we are where we are.
Yes, well, true. And the free bus is a great asset. No question.
Does the free bus serve those areas as well, even if they're not in Iowa?
It's up at Gulf Mill, which goes up.
The bus can't go down every single street, so it is what it is.
And have we ever decided whether we are the best library for the people who are so far from us?
We are their library, they're paying taxes to us.
I know, but if it's closer for them to walk to another library, would they do that?
Oh, they do.
But, and children tend to just go where they can get to.
Correct.
So maybe our concentration on them, is that well thought out? I mean, do they prefer where they're going because it's convenient? Do we not need to be that concerned?
I mean, some of them are closer to the Des Plaines Public Libraries when they go there, but there are many of them that don't go anywhere because they don't have transportation or they don't have a parent that can get them places. That's what we heard quite a bit from the education group, is they're concerned that we have this beautiful library down here with all this stuff going on, but they don't feel like their kids can get here very well. And so it's to look at ways that we could possibly help them get the kids down here in some way.
Did you determine if those are Niles?
Yeah, those are.
Well, then that bus would definitely...
Well, Niles Public Library District residents.
Mm-hmm. But you didn't determine if they're in Niles or if they're in another suburb?
Many of them are unincorporated Des Plaines.
Because I know for a fact we have some at school that are unincorporated Des Plaines who have talked to me about the Niles Library. Because they're in our district.
Unincorporated Des Plaines is offered off in Milwaukee, correct?
That is a lot of it, yes.
It's part of it.
I thought it was further over by Main East.
And some of it is closer to...
By Main East, further west?
Further west. Yeah, the maps.
All right, because I'm thinking D is unincorporated, or not D, I'm thinking by that public storage, and that's close to Milwaukee, but you're right, it could be further west. And that Niles is nowhere in there. There's no way that bus can, there's just one street that they can all go.
I know for a fact on Dempster, it only goes to that shot by Jewel, and then that's as far west as it goes.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's unincorporated by D too.
So back to my comments on this then, that expanded community engagement, I'd be okay with taking off that bullet point, the very first one, develop the task force. I think that's just, again, I'm not real happy with the whole idea of creating a secondary or tertiary or fourth location. This is our library, it's here.
I think in support of Tim's suggestion, I think maybe we could think of ways that it's possible for them to somehow get here rather than us, like he said, expand.
I think that's the village's responsibility, the village, the free bus for the owners. We are a car suburb.
That's true, and luckily we have that bus. But
you can get anywhere at Niles in 10 minutes.
And you know, until you try to engage the people in that area, and that was your meeting with two people. So I don't know if the library is not prepared to actually get involved with these different ethnicities, or maybe it's just out of our reach in terms of logistics. But I have to agree with him on that.
I mean, it's not like we've had people come to these board meetings complaining that they haven't had access.
No, some of them don't even know where their library. Change will help with that.
Don't they send out the quarterly news bulletin to everybody?
Well, you know, if you're in a big building, they are just like thrown into the lobby.
Well, you see them when you live in a condo. You see all that stuff they throw there. Mm-hmm.
So, you know, my feeling is that they are taxpayers and we need to figure out ways to serve them.
I hear what you're saying. I'm just not hearing the evidence that anybody is coming forward and demanding that they get the service. I'm not hearing it. All I'm hearing is anecdotal, you know, thinking they might.
Well, I think that would be part of what a task force would be looking at, I think. I actually take Carolyn's point that this first process was talking to a few people. One thing that did become very clear to me is that we do need to spend more time talking to people, and that was partly why I put in the section on focused staff development, because there's the training that you can do to develop more ongoing conversations with your community.
That's great.
And I think that we need to be doing more of that. I think we need to focus more on continuous communication and not, you know, asking them every 5 years, hey, what do you think of the library?
And I'm on board with that, too. Absolutely.
And I think this, and the fourth piece, the enhanced community alignment, will kind of pair with the expanded community engagement, because once you get that marketing done and you actually can target, then can actually reach out further there also. So those kind of pair together. Because once we actually work on this, on the enhanced community awareness, then it can kind of, that will help, number two.
Can I just make a suggestion?
Those kind of work together.
On that point of enhancing or educating your staff, it takes several years to engage your staff in so many different workshops and so many other committees that are out there to help you better understand different nationalities and everything. I mean, I think our five-year plan will be close to the end once everyone's become an expert. And I think removing the first bullet point may be something you can consider later if just automatically other things didn't fall into place, like children become older and drive driving more cars or whatever, but enhancing their staff would probably be primary, which would again not necessitate the first bullet point, I think.
The task force.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I think you're right about the staff development taking time. I just think that
just
the 5-year plan.
Just it's the, it's, the, it's what's involved in cultural education.
But you know, I think we did hear from the focus groups that expanded service in the northwest part of the district is something we need to be doing. So that's why it's here. I did not add that. That was
very right.
And just because we have a task force, does that necessarily mean we have to act on, or just, that doesn't mean we have to spend buku bucks, it doesn't mean we have to open a new branch, all that, it just, the task force is to help us find out.
Right.
It's just an informational thing.
Right.
And I have a focus.
Yeah. I personally have no problem with gathering as much information as we can, so that we can better make a decision.
Okay, so how about if I added the phrase gather information and explore options?
Personally, I think that's a good idea because, I mean, if people are thinking that means we're going to, you know, develop something up north, we're not necessarily saying
that's not the point.
That's not the point. The point is to get as much information as possible so we can best help or take care of our community that pays our taxes.
And make a more informed decision.
Exactly.
So are you removing the task force or elaborating on its purpose?
Adding the phrase, develop a task force to gather information and explore options for expanded service. So the gather information comes first.
Gather information, I mean,
let me just clarify what changes
okay. You
requested because, okay, the one we just covered,
mm-hmm.
Tim has asked that the first outcome be changed to take out regardless of location or cultural background and put in for all of its patrons.
Right.
Which I don't know.
It's reasonable.
Regardless of location or cultural background. Right, and just so the library is easy to use for all patrons.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Great.
Mm-hmm.
I think that sounds very reasonable.
All right, and then Rob had mentioned the identifying barriers to customer service and communication as being, you know, almost more important than what we have here as the goal. I thought what I might do is experiment with breaking this into two separate goals and having it be, connecting the right people with the right information content at the right time in the right way is one thing, and then the identifying barriers to customer service kind of splitting. So I'll experiment with that a little bit if that's all right.
Mm-hmm.
Is there anything else that anybody said that you want that's going to be a sticking point next month? Okay, if you think of anything later, please do let me know.
Can I just ask one clarification? I'm sorry, then I'll drop it. The value is promotional. Oh, promotional. Never mind, I got it. Thank you. That was the key word.
All right.
Okay. All right, thank you for
and thank you very much.
Thank you.
great delivery.
Okay, so do I have a motion to approve the expenditure not to exceed $19,000 to purchase a three-year support agreement from Hewlett Packard covering the library's virtualization server hardware?
So moved.
Barb? I'll take it.
Now, what is this under? What number on that?
This is C, this 11C.
No, this is C? Okay. Oh, now I see it's 19.
All right, so I understand this is an extension of the current agreement. So can you explain that, please?
So we bought servers in 2011. And those servers are, those appliances have a number of servers on them which help us to run the business of the library. As part of that, we bought a five-year support product from Hewlett Packard, which provided software and hardware support, and that has now expired. The equipment is still in service. And we feel it's important to continue the service agreement. Actually, the service agreement goes to the beginning of April. So we're just a couple of weeks away. So it's important to have a service agreement. Should one of those servers go down, they get parts and repairs and so forth, so that we can continue with operations.
And they're still in good working order?
Yeah.
Everything is okay?
Yeah, I mean, one way to look at it is Hewlett Packard would not be interested in extending us a service agreement if they were broken down and smoke was coming out. But they are in good order. We have maintained them through the last five-year service agreement, and we should continue doing that. And then in 3 years, we'll probably replace them.
Okay. Any further discussion?
Greg, can you tell us how this rate compares to the rate that we checked into before?
I don't have that information in this room, but I could...
I guess I just want to know, do you think that's a reasonable number?
Yeah. Well, so what Hewlett Packard does is they're part of WSCA. And what WSCA does is basically they go out to all of these vendors and they pre-negotiate all of these contracts. And one of the ways that we could buy equipment without having to bid it, because WSCA is going to be the best price you can get for a governmental agency, is that instead of spending a lot of time bidding and getting different vendors to give us different prices for basically the same product, is that in the area that we're in, covered by WSCA, everybody pays the same price. And because it's a Hewlett Packard server array, we're tied basically to the Hewlett Packard service product or support product.
Okay, well that's good to know. They don't just pull a number out of the air.
If we didn't have this pre-bid price list to work off of, we would actually go out and be required to go out under the board rules and get three bids. Even though this is under the statement of 20,000. Over 20,000 were required by state rules to go out.
Thanks, Greg.
Is that,
I
think
it's state agency or state organization that's
going? I don't think it's...
WISKA, WSCCA.
I don't think it's part of the state. I think it's like an independent association, that charges a membership fee,
okay,
and that provides a service to all its members. I could get you more information about that.
That's interesting. Okay.
Any
Barbara?
Yes.
Rob?
Yes.
Tim?
Yes.
Carolyn?
Yes.
Pam?
Yes.
Karen?
Yes.
Okay. Number 12, unfinished business. Approved policy 4.31, no solicitation, no distribution. distribution. Okay, so I'm now bringing back to the table the new policy, personnel policy 4.31, no solicitation, no distribution, as previously moved by trustee Spadoni and seconded by trustee Diamond. Susan, can you remind us why we tabled this policy last week?
Yes. A couple of months ago, Tim had raised the question that it didn't exclude, you know, this is the one about staff trying to sell things or get people to, you know, sponsor them and things like that, soliciting financial contributions. And Tim made the very good point that it didn't take out things that were library property that we would be selling. They would be selling in the course of their job. We added a line about that. This rule does not apply to materials being sold or given out by the library district. And then Dennis Walsh indicated that he didn't like the last line of this policy, which applied it to patrons as well as to staff, because he thought that was an infringement of First Amendment rights, free speech rights. So I took that out altogether. So now it is just the bare bones, that staff cannot use work time to try to promote their own personal causes or sell anything to other staff.
And that was the original purpose of this?
That is
to address staff.
Yes, it's in the personnel part of the handbook.
So I'm sure after the pull the whole thing apart.
Yeah, exactly. And that's also why I sent the rules back to Dennis for him to look at that aspect of it there.
I get it. All right.
Okay, any further discussion? Okay, Diane, please take the roll.
Who made the motion for that?
It was Tony.
It was previously. Oh, okay. Okay, so it's
Tim
and Karen. I don't think we had a motion.
It was me.
It got tabled. It's brought back from your table.
Oh, okay.
So, Tim?
Yes.
Carolyn?
Yes.
Patty?
Yes.
Linda?
Yes.
Karen?
Yes.
Barbara?
Yes.
Rob?
Yes.
Okay, executive session.
We think we're going to need one unless you want. I thought I might, but I don't.
Okay. All right. We do not need an executive session. Final action, if any, on closed session. Nope, we don't have that. Any other?
Question that's about coming again.
Yes, ma'am.
The ALA annual conference, as in the past, you usually suggest that we attend the PLA, the Public Library Association, as opposed to the ALA.
Well, there, when it's here, I think it's a great idea to go when it's here down at the Department of Library. So you can attend all the sessions and go to the, particularly go to the exhibits. It is, the PLA exhibits are very focused on public libraries, but the ALA exhibits are enormous. So there's a lot of stuff there. Right. But the sessions are also very good, and the speakers are also very good, and it's here, so it's a good opportunity.
So, but there is a registration fee.
There is a registration fee. Yes.
An earlier registration.
So,
and when is early 22nd?
Oh, yeah. Really?
No.
So,
that's it's pretty quick. Well, what's the fee, do you know, for?
I know it is for y'all.
It's different for different groups of people. So I will look that up and send that out to you tomorrow.
Now, if you have a registration fee, then that would cover if you went whenever you went.
Yes, correct. And at least you don't have a hotel.
Would you have marked me down for a yes?
Great.
Yeah, me too.
What's the date?
But now you're June
23rd.
June
23rd to June. It's only 27, right?
Oh, it June 23rd. No, never mind. Don't put me out. Don't put me down. I'm not going to be able to walk.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm thinking maybe.
She's telling me she can't make the meeting, but she's going to ALA.
No, I'm not going to ALA. It just dawned on me. It's June. It's not May. So I'm thinking if it was May, I could do it. But it's not. It's June. Never mind.
And is registration the same amount with you go one day or
more? No, it's different. So I will get you all of that information.
An hour.
All right. So you'll email us.
I will email you tomorrow, I promise.
So put me as a no then. I just wanted to throw that out.
Thank you. Okay. I appreciate your concern.
All right. Can I have yays for meeting adjourned?
Yes.
Was there anything else?
Yes.
Okay. Yay. Yeah. Thank you very much, everyone.